About 800 metres left. Bedford having a breather and a blow then. Two laps show on the chart. Great Britain leads, Finland second, East Germany third, Spain four, Russia five. And in sixth place is Karitsa. And Bedford trying everything now with a lap and three quarters, but they won't let him go. Vaatainen looks desperately dangerous in second place. Haro so comfortable third. Haase the double champion fourth. And in fifth place, Sherefitinov, the drop Karitsa with a lap and a half left. The battle for the three medals now between this group of five. And Karitsa working desperately to get back. This a race that's worth its label as possibly the greatest of the game. And it comes on the opening night. Bedford still looks reasonably easy. But one wonders whether he's got the finishing pace. And Karitsa's now back with the leading six. There's 3 yards covering the leading six, and the bell is time. Bedford for Britain, Vaatainen of Finland, Haase East Germany, Haro Spain, Sherefitinov Russia, and Karitsa of Yugoslavia, and this will be a last lap to remember. And Vaatainen of Finland and Haase of Germany, the Finn of the East German have left them, and it's Vaatainen of Finland. Can he sustain this pace? And Bedford's been left way, way, way back. It's the Finn who leads. The champion is second. The Russian is third. And Bedford beaten for speed. About 30, 40 yards behind. It's Finland versus East Germany. And the crowd going berserk. Haase, the champion, coming under their side. They are tied on the curve. 80 metres left. And what a finish! Probably the greatest 10,000 metres ever, and the Finn wins it. Vaatainen wins, and Haase is defeated. Sherefitinov is third, Karitsa fourth, Haro fifth, and Bedford sixth. And that a fantastic run, a last lap that will go down in history.